So we'll start by settling the body, adopting a stable, comfortable, upright position, serviceable for meditation. So we think about keeping our feet flat and our back straight, torso open, hands in the lap right over left with the palms upturned, and the thumbs gently touching. Your eyes are gently closed or slightly open, making sure we let in enough light to remain alert. We try to avoid slouching or leaning. We also let go of any unnecessary tension or rigidity in the body, relaxing into a stable, comfortable, upright position. And begin to cultivate the sense of letting go of attending to the outside, allowing sights and sounds to be as they are without investigation. Constraining your awareness just to the body and mind. Concentrating that awareness on the present by attending closely to the physical sensation of the air moving into and back out the tip of the nostrils. Noticing quickly when anything other than that one physical sensation is arising in the mind, and without judgment or frustration, lifting your awareness up from those distractions and placing it gently but firmly again and again on the breath. The mind becomes more calm, generate a broad and altruistic motivation. taking a moment to intentionally widen your circle of concern. I think that the purpose of our time is to establish and deepen beneficial ways of thinking and acting to reduce and ultimately eliminate the tendencies and the habits that are not productive. Wanting to generate states of mind that spontaneously give rise to actions that are beneficial for others and decrease the prevalence of those states of mind that often give rise to actions that cause harm to others. Genuinely transforming the mind in this way in order to be of greater and greater benefit to sentient beings. With that motivation, we will today contemplate the continuity of mind and its implications for our spiritual growth and development. We begin by turning to the mind in the present. Observing the arising and falling away of mental events. It's like a passive, neutral observer. and try to recollect the experiences that you've had between waking up and right now. Let us see if there are any connections. Any thread during this period of time. And continue to trace the continuity of the mind backward, thinking about yesterday, late last week, last month. Going further and further back. One year. 5 years. Just keep progressing backward and observing. Trying to get a sense of the continuity of mental events. going back even to the earliest childhood memories. Not analyzing good or bad experiences, but connecting with the mind's continuity. So each moment of mind is connected to the one before and the one after. Bring the mind back forward in time. Up through the present again. And begin projecting the mind forward. Thinking of later today, later this week, having seen how these mental moments are connected in one continuous, unbroken stream of mental events. Contemplate what you would like the content of the mind to be in 5 years, 10 years. At the end of your life, the and try to identify the causes of accomplishing those goals. Where to put your energy and focus. To create the causes and the conditions of those changes. And then make a strong determination to begin moving in that direction, implementing that plan. With the understanding of the mind's continuity and cause and effect nature. These are the causes that I must bring about. Being strongly determined to accomplish that. And then when you're ready, we'll come back together. And we'll dedicate. So recollect your altruistic motivation and think that by having contemplated in this way, you actualize that motivation, which has created positive energy in the mind. And think that that positive energy will ripen in beneficial ways in the future. You offer the fruit of your practice for the benefit of all sentient beings without exception. May that positive energy become a cause and condition to eliminate war and conflict, poverty, famine, disease, disasters, all painful inner and outer conditions. May it fully ripen the minds of all sentient beings. May they quickly meet perfect teachers and arise in the state of full enlightenment. May I too achieve the state of enlightenment in order to work for the benefit of sentient beings perfectly. May any obstacles facing the Guru's long life be completely dispelled, and may I and all sentient beings in this moment come under the joyful care and guidance of enlightened beings. May we be guided and protected until we swiftly achieve that state of enlightenment. Thank you.